Once upon a time, Wittle Wabbit was eating his breakfast. It was a beautiful summer day, and Wittle Wabbit was going to play in the meadow. "Now you be careful," said Mother Wabbit while she ladled out a bowl of carrot porridge. "The old well on the way to the meadow was very dangerous. I want you to promise me that you'll go straight there without stopping." Wittle Wabbit was a very obedient young wabbit and always listened to his mum.
"Yes, Mother,"
he said.
"I will go straight there. I promise."
Hopping down the path on the way to the meadow, Wittle Wabbit saw something strange. Four little green stalks wiggling and waving about. What could it be? Why, it was old Mr. Turtle, flipped on his back.
"What are you doing, Mr. Turtle?"
asked Wittle Wabbit.
"I have fallen on my shell and I can't get up, young child,"
said Mr. Turtle.
"Can you help flip me back over?"
"Not right now,"
said Wittle Wabbit.
"I promised Mother I would go straight to the meadow. I can't help you."
Wittle Wabbit knew he was getting close to the meadow. He could smell the scent of the honeysuckles that grew there and hear the distant laughter of his young friends. But something else caught his attention. It was the old well just off the path. Wittle Wabbit decided to take a quick peek. What could be so dangerous about it? The well was so deep that the bottom was pitch black. Wittle Wabbit wondered how deep it was. And as he was peering in,
the stone ledge suddenly crumbled and Wittle Wabbit found himself falling in.
He heard a snap as both his little wabbit legs broke under him, for the well had run dry for the summer.
"Help!"
Wittle Wabbit cried.
"Help, help! Help, help, help!"
Old Mr. Turtle came slowly past.
"I do not think I will help you, young child, for when I needed you to flip me over, you quickly hopped on by."
"Help, help, help! Help! Help, help! Help, 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 help! Help! Help, 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 help! Help, help! Help!"
The next spring, water had returned to the old well as it did every year. A frog who happened by decided to pull up the bucket and take a drink.
"Uh-oh,"
said the frog as he saw what was in the bucket.
"Whose bones are these?"
And so the frog went to the rabbit's house. Because, you see, the bones he found in the bucket looked like rabbit bones.
"Hello,"
called the frog, knocking on the rabbit's door. A kindly old mole answered the door, peering through his spectacles at the frog.
"How can I help you?"
said the mole.
"I'm sorry,"
said the frog.
"I was looking for Mrs. Rabbit. I believe I have discovered what happened to her son."
"Oh, my,"
said the mole, seeing what was in the bucket.
"I'm afraid Mrs. Rabbit moved away to the city soon after her son's disappearance. I'm terribly sorry."
"As am I,"
said the frog.
"As am I."
The end.